Well, that shall be Zulus here. I think this might be more useful, but at the same time, going out and helping an old friend, that's more my style of thing. So, let's go after Lapino. You can't make new old friends. The rebellion was out of time, and Reynard needed a game changer. Even though Lapino wasn't what anyone would consider a game changer, he could come up with some harebrained schemes. Maybe rescuing him was worth it.
Ah, Lapino. Apparently, the mad rabbit had sold a Pegasus that he did not exactly own. Lapino always wiggled out of trouble, given time. But he was out of time. The Ravens had figured out that Lapino was a rebel spy. If the fleet reached him first, they'd string him up for that. Never mind the winged horse.
I love the book art style they have too. I wonder if they have released those pictures somewhere.
Lapino had apparently managed to confuse the judge by arguing that he hadn't actually stolen a winged horse. He'd only sold it. But wait, where was the prison? The village was empty. Had everybody fled the Ravens? Bernardo's blood was up. He just needed to smash something.
Oh, nice. Few more ores. And little bit of health too. Let's open that. Can we actually make anything? Oh! Game socketing. This is augmenting my skills and 3 games can be equipped. Let's see. Do I have any? No, I don't. Each game has 3 levels and its effect increases with each level. Picking up game you already have will automatically upgrade the game's level. You can find games in chests scattered throughout Boreas if you are lucky enough. Okay. And what do I need for lots of ores? Quite a lot of them. Well, I guess I might just have to keep my eyes open then.
Renato wondered if it wasn't cheaper to build bridges and stairs.
Well, there's a stairway over there.
People were frightened these days. Just 2 weeks passed, Renardo had sneaked through an empty town and listened to the Raven's call about the Emperor's new taste in ritual sacrifice.
That doesn't sound good.
Firewalls only let you through if they think you're hot enough.
And I guess I need that fire sword for that. Oh well. Also, what is this? I have no idea. I guess I have to do something behind that fire door to activate that. And here's a level up altar. Can we actually level up? No, we still lack skill points. Can't get through there, but we can open this at least. Few more ores. Let's open this door. And ravens. Oh, well, counter that. down. One behind. Two behind. That went much better.
Ravens were landing everywhere.
Still
the advanced
not
guard.
Very good.
He'd better get moving.
According
if they got to
Lupino
that. First, they'd eat him for breakfast. Or a snack. Ravens weren't picky. If they got hungry, they sometimes forgot to interrogate their prisoners. Even top spies like Lupino.
Yeah, that doesn't
sound
cool.
Mad rabbit got to?
So, what's the history behind Lupino and Leonardo? I like to know that myself. Let's get these open. Ah, there's a chest over there. Let's get that. Great, more essences and ores. And we can level up
Renato
here.
Renato felt like he was ready to learn new things. Thank goodness he didn't have to go to school for that.
So we can only pick that. So control to do supernatural dash.
Started to come back to him. Something you never completely forgot. Like how to freeze time when attacking. The more he fought, the more he'd probably remember.
Ah, like that. That's going to be quite useful. That was close one. Can I get through this without getting hit? Yeah. Got perfect out of that. Nice to see quick evaluation of a fighter right after it.
Renato felt a chill run down his back. Or possibly a flea.
I think it's a chill considering this is graveyard. At least this looks like a graveyard. And that's, I guess, is a void sword door. Still lacking skill points. Shouldn't last for much longer now.
Renato was remembering all his old tricks and some new ones. Now he really ought to ask for a raise.
Let's get that level up. And bonus damage and double combo. Slow down time after successful counter until your next action. That sounds like a useful thing. Yeah, let's take that time.
He missed his old skills. He welcomed them back like he was at a reunion.
And let's see how we can handle that. Hello, you must be Lupino.
Dirty and bloody, Renato finally reached Lupino. The rabbit was practicing his shuffle. Renato recognized the cards. It was Lupino's favorite deck. Oh, I thought you were in danger. I am. The ravens are coming. Oh, the prison thing. Right, yeah, we see this guard owed me 53 ducats, so we made a deal. They're very reasonable people, actually, for weasels. Now, I got a brilliant plan to kidnap Zenobia.
We
Zenobia.
We find out what she knows.
I think she might be right Emperor's daughter.
Lemon squeezy.
Capture the Emperor's greatest general, who also happens to be a deadly sorcerer, and his only daughter. That would be worth it.
I was wondering right there.
He could still get to the core of the Sky Ripper, even if he couldn't get the whole thing. It must have great power.
So, let's see. Should we go after this core? Or actually trust the Lapino's plan? We could actually get some extra intel that the rebels could use from her. Let's go after Zenobia, I think. Pay a call on Zenobia. Reynardo and Lapino were back together, but Reynardo still needed a game changer to save the rebellion. Maybe Lapino was right. Maybe they should go kidnap the Emperor's only daughter and greatest general, Zenobia. Extracting intel out of her would turn the tide in the civil war. Yeah, I think so too. Let's head after
wasn't
her.
Zenobia just the Emperor's daughter, of course. She'd been Renato's best friend in Sword Fu School.
Of course.
And you're still mad for her, the rabbit reminded him. They'd been close. She'd told him things no one else knew. But she'd never told him who she really was. She knows all the Emperor's plans, chuckled the Master Spy. She won't give them up easily. She'll tell the interrogators, all right, said Lapino. Taking her would change the game, all right.
Yeah, kind of. I think so, too. But if Reynardo has feelings for her, that's going to complicate things, I think.
The city was already under Zenobia's control. I had to admire her efficiency. Renato shivered at the thought of Zenobia at the mercy of the interrogators. Could he really turn her over to them? But this was war. It wasn't meant to be pretty.
Yeah, war can get ugly. On both sides. Nothing over here. They know how to build an atmosphere here.
Here then, a little sword. Ice wall. Ice. Cube.
Yeah, and this will need that ice ward. And little bit of sneaking here. Get this horse from that chest and then
Whoa.
Down you go.
If looks could kill.
No. Oh no. Whoa. That hurt. I'm getting stuck here. One down. Oh no. This side. And there's one more down. No. And you're going down. And sneaking behind you. There we go. And now route should be clear.
That was new. Most people still use doorknobs.
You have to admit, that was a good, amazing. So, anything in here doesn't look like it. And Lapino's over here.
So, what's this plan of yours?
Use me as bait, said Lapino.
Wait, what?
And he outlined a slightly complicated plan that involved geese, a net, setting the farfare a little bit on fire, Lapino dressing as an old blind toad, and Renardo hiding inside a monstrous watermelon.
What could possibly go wrong? Thought Renardo.
That's one of the craziest themes I heard. And not the most sane one, and I don't want to pick that. But it sounds so amazing. I want to see that in action. Let's go for Lapino's cheese net fire toad watermelon band.
Oh, this is gonna be fun.
I agree.
As he ran to go set up his marvelous plan.
If
it's crazy, but
now,
it's gonna be really short.
I'm guessing I don't have enough materials. Yeah, still lacking quite a few. Yeah, just continuing normally. No new skill points. But more ravens here.
Come over here.
And I'm stuck here. Oh. Alright, I forgot I had that time slowing. Oh, that looked amazing. Too bad I accidentally got a hit there. Also, that slowness in here was strange. Also, now that I look at it, looks like I'm floating in the air here. That's strange.
Renardo felt dubious about the whole plan. With every step, he was waiting
for all to go horribly wrong.
But against all odds, Pino's idiotic plan worked. Zenobia's ravens ran off after the geese, the net dropped, and Renardo jumped out of the watermelon and put his sword to Zenobia's throat.
Renardo, she said.
I wanted to see that.
Are those new scars? They look good on you.
You never return my velvet jacket. It was my favorite.
You look stupid in velvet.
Oh, what does an imperial princess know about style? Oh, get a room, you two, said Latino.
But the fleet was coming on fast, so they put Zenobia on the Farfarer and took her east over the Nexus. She'd vanished from Swordfu School. From his life, without even saying goodbye. Without ever telling him she was the Emperor's adopted daughter.
Ah, Lapina was right, Renardo thought reluctantly. She knows things. She recognized
his look. Yeah, sounds like
it. You're taking me to the interrogators, aren't you? She said, wide-eyed. And then she jumped, with horror.
Wait, what?
Renardo saw Zenobia plummeting. Then he
saw
the
next. How did you let her jump?
Cats always land on their feet.
Ah, oh, she'll head for the Imperial Outpost, yelled Lapino. You have to catch her.
Well, time to chase after her.
Cats can run faster, but foxes can run longer. If he ran, he could head her off before she reached her minions at the outpost. Well, he did love a good chase. Oh, this really didn't have much in the way of safety features, did it?
This place looks interesting. Not to mention this music in background. Lovingly soothed. Pikachu thing, I think it's the correct term. So...
Who needed bridges anyway?
Oh. I wonder what happens to people that actually wall off from these islands. And let me guess, there's an enemy group here as soon as I enter. Yeah, I know. What are you? About Warlock's fire spell. Ah, Warlocks. Okay, and explodey time. Let's skip that thing. That was maybe a little bit too easy. I should really stop after a counterattack, so I can plan what to do. But on the other hand, that still went quite well. No new ores there. Can I get over there? Yes. It was worth taking that.
I wonder what I can make with all these sword crafting materials, thought Renato.
Well, there's not really much to make out of them. Just the swords, but what kinds? Yeah, I sounded stupid.
He was
there.
Closing on her. He could smell her fear. He tried not to think about the interrogators at the secret base. What did they do to her? Maybe it didn't have to end that way. Maybe he could talk to her. But
maybe.
After all, there were worse things the Imperials had done to friends of his.
And that's also a good point. It's kind of issues of war. What you do? Do you want to go as low as the enemy has done?
A crafting bench. Renato wondered what he could make with it.
Let's see what level 2 hero sword. Allows me to heal myself. Sure, why not? Hold shift to activate the swords. Consume energy when activated. And scroll wheel to switch them. Okay. And time to continue. Ooh, that's a big chest. Can I get there anyway? Can't see any reasonable way to get over that side. This one. Off you go. And my streak was taken down.
Renato reached the outpost. The Imperials there were no match for him. Soon after, Zenobia limped up the path. When she realized he was already in front of her, she didn't even try to run.
Yeah.
Oh, you left without saying goodbye. Again, he said, please. You're enjoying this a little too much.
Am I?
She said, shaken. Oh, spare us the chit-chat, would you? Said Lupino as he shackled her hands so she couldn't throw spells. She knows all his plans, all the way back to the Farfaro.
Lupino nagged Renato about how the interrogators would pry all the intel out of Zenobia. I thought would turn the tides in the imminent battle. All they had to do was take her to the rebel's secret base. Renato didn't like to think about what the interrogators would do to her. Couldn't he just talk to her?
Well, he could, but I'm not sure if that's a correct choice to make.